Welcome to Policy Times. I'm Abhinav Raj. Today we are talking about something that's quite undiscussed in our country. We are talking about mental health, and with us is Ms. Swati Bajpai. Ma'am, could you just introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm a behavioral health professional. I work with the public health in US. I work with the government. In US, the behavioral health is as important as the physical health, so that's why the government provides services for that.
Has mental health been a worrying factor for people worldwide, and why is it so?
Mental health has been a worrying factor from forever, just like physical health. It is something for which we need help. Nowadays, people are talking more about it, that's it, but it's not that something which is new. It's as old as human body.
There has been rise in number of suicides, and we see that most young people, when they don't achieve their target or they don't get what they want, they take the extreme step. Why is it so?
A lot of times, young people, especially if you're talking about teenagers, they're already going through the hormonal changes that happen with that age. So they're already struggling with their identity. They're trying to find themselves. Meanwhile, I'm going to talk right here about is the Indian society, the kind of pressure that is there from society, from family to excel, which is, again, very, I don't know what excellence in that, but regarding how much of percentage they're getting. So that kind of constant pressure to prove themselves, parents only asking about how their studies are going. Nobody ever asks, how are you feeling today? Did you do anything to feel good about yourself? Did you do anything to relax? So under pressure like that, anything can break. Even a machine would break. So in this case, it's a delicate, tender, young mind which is still developing. It's like a flower which is in the process of blooming, and before that kind of pressure is crushing it down.
Are we living in the times of hyper ambitions?
You could say, because especially the kind of population pressure, again, there is a lot of pressure for ambition. Hyper of anything, as I would say, is bad. But by itself, ambition is not a bad thing. That is what takes us forward, that brought us from Stone Age to today where we are. But you have to be ambitious not only for degrees and money. You have to be ambitious also to have a good life, to have successful relationships, to be a productive part of your community. What are you contributing to the society from which you are taking all the time? That is also ambition. So as long as people are ambitious, all round ambitious, there's nothing wrong, because then you would be focusing and taking care of your mental health.
And how do you look at Indian government's approach towards mental health in general and at policy level?
Very dismal, because just 2013 is the time when the first mental health bill apparently came about. There are no bodies which regulate mental health professionals. There is no criteria who can call themselves as mental health professionals. In the Western world, the guidelines and the expectations are very rigid, very strict. While I was a student, I had to work 600 hours under a licensed clinical social worker. Now while I'm working, while first 2 years, which was almost 3,000 hours of work, I had to do under, again, my boss, which is, she's all a licensed clinical social worker. Only then I become eligible to appear for the exam. Again, all that process is, again, very, very stringent. Then I can go in for examination. Again, those examinations are tough. But even after you become a licensed professional, that is, I can have a private practice, I can bill the insurance directly, every 2 years, if you're not following up, you have to have continued education, otherwise you lose your license. And even a professor over there does not start practicing therapy, because for that you have to have a different license. You could be a teacher, but not necessarily a therapist.
How can it be improved in India?
They have to come up with a lot of body. Right now it's baby steps. There's a lot of infrastructure that needs to be developed. It's almost 150 years behind the Western world.
And the last question, how can someone tackle depression individually, if you could give some suggestions to our audience?
Depression, there are two kind of depression. One is situational, the other is the major depressive, which is the chemical imbalance. For that, there is nothing else which is going to work besides medication. And there is nothing wrong about taking medication. We take medication for diabetes, we take medication for thyroid. So if we're taking medication for depression, anxiety, somebody has bipolar, schizophrenia or anything, it's what an illness that is there for which medications are available, why not avail it? But as I was mentioning about major depressive disorder, depression, anytime you get it, it is like fog. You cannot drive through it. You cannot walk fast through it because you're not able to see clearly. So similarly, when you have depression, it's like there is a fog in the mind. Take the medication, let the fog clear up. If it is something for which you need behavioral changes, you would go in for therapy. If it's a situation like a death in the family, loss in the business, breakup of a relationship, for that, sometimes you're able to come out by yourself, talking to your family, friends. But otherwise, have a healthy lifestyle, have a routine, stay connected to nature, spend 15 days, everybody. That is like you go for exercise, you have to do something for your mental health. That is, spend 15 minutes every day doing something that makes you happy. Don't worry about everybody else. That 15 minutes ideally should be yours. It could be gardening, it could be walking, exercising. Exercises release happy hormones, which again are good for us. So I would say having a balanced life is important for our mental health and even physical health. They are correlated. People who have diabetes will have depression. People who have depression have higher chances of developing diabetes.
Thank you, ma'am, for talking to us. So we had with us Ms. Swati Bajpai, and we had a quite brainstorming interaction on mental health. We'll be back with same kind of interactions in future. Keep watching the Policy Times. Thank you.